Hi, I'm Georgia Williams, the energy reporter here at INN. Let's take a look at what happened in the energy sector during the month of June. The month started with Canadian uranium explorer Denison announcing it was moving ahead into the environmental study phase at its Wheeler project in Saskatchewan's Athabasca Basin. The company has already received approval from the Nuclear Regulatory Agency and the Canadian federal government in order to progress to this stage. The company plans to build an in-situ mining process at Wheeler because it believes that traditional mining is too impactful on the environment. Across the border in the U.S., a House subcommittee met to discuss extending the Grand Canyon uranium mining ban, which was first implemented by former President Obama in 2012. The issue was raised because President Trump has recently announced that he plans on extending domestic resource production across the board. Later in the month, the Supreme Court upheld a Virginia uranium mining ban, which has been in place since 1982. The case was brought forward on the behalf of Virginia Uranium and Virginia Energy. The companies believe it's unconstitutional that they aren't allowed to mine for uranium on their private property, which is owned by one of the company founders. The current spot price for U308 is $24.45 per pound, down from last month's price of $24.65 per pound. Over in the oil and gas sector, the month started with UK-based Hurricane Energy announcing it had produced its initial barrels of oil from the fractured basement field offshore of the country. The Lancaster Field is the country's first basement reservoir to enter production on the continental shelf. On this side of the pond, the federal government has approved the expansion of the Trans Mountain Pipeline, which currently runs between Alberta and BC. Once expanded, the capacity of the pipeline will almost triple, from the 300,000 barrels per day that it currently produces to more than 890,000. Despite being a contentious issue on both sides of the Alberta and BC border, Prime Minister Trudeau remains hopeful that the project will unite the country because he plans on spending money raised from the pipeline on green initiatives around the country. The current price of Brent crude is $64.11 a barrel, while West Texas crude is $57.90 a barrel. That's it from the energy sector for the month of June. Make sure to check back next month to find out what happened in the month of July. In the meantime, you can follow us on LinkedIn, Twitter, or Facebook.